Hey guys, welcome back to another new video by Biology with Zhang Shen. So today we are going to do the 0610/62 May-June 2023, the paper 6 alternative to practical paper. So this is the paper 6 that I have done during my June 2023 series, and the link of this paper is in the description box below, and please check it out. So let's start off by looking at the answers. Okay. All right. Question 1. Some animals live in cold places. They sometimes huddle together as shown in figure 1.1. A student investigated the effect of huddling on heat loss from model animals. Test tube containing hot water represented the animals. The student used the method described in step 1 to step 10. Step 1, place a test tube in an empty beaker and put a thermometer into the test tube. Step 2, approximately half fill the test tube with hot water and start the stop clock. Step 3, after 1 minute, record the temperature of the hot water in the test tube. Figure 1.2 is a diagram part of the thermometer from step 3. Record the temperature shown in figure 1.2. So the answer here is 68.5 degrees. As you can see from here, let me just highlight this. When you see it's 68.5 because it's hitting here. So that's why it's a 68.5. Okay, step 4. Record the temperature of the hot water in test tube every minute for a total of 5 minutes. Step 5. Put 3 identical test tubes together and keep them in place with an elastic band as shown in figure 1.3. Place the group of 3 test tubes in an empty beaker. Okay, as you can show in the picture. Step 6. Half fill all the 3 test tubes with hot water and put a thermometer into one of the test tubes. Step 7. Record the temperature in the test tube at 1 minute intervals for a total of 5 minutes. Step 8. Put 7 identical test tubes together and keep them in place with an elastic band as shown in figure 1.4. Place the group of 7 test tubes in an empty beaker. Okay. Step 9. Half fill all the 7 test tubes with hot water and put a thermometer into a central test tube. Step 10. Record the temperature in the test tube at 1 minute interval for a total of 5 minutes. Okay. Figure 1.5 shows the result the students recorded in their notebook. Okay, so this is the results shown in figure 1.5. Prepare a table and record the results shown in figure 1.5 and your answer to 1A1. Okay, so basically the 1A part 1 was 68.5. That's where you put your answer as 68.5. So you have to draw a table which is 3 marks. We must have at least 4 columns minimum, 4 headings I mean. Yeah, 4 columns, 4 headings, or columns. Okay, so that's just the minimum. And then you also just need to fill in all 14 results and units together at the same time. So the units are the temperature degrees Celsius. Okay, alright, question part 3. Plot a line graph on a grid of a temperature against time. Include all 3 sets of data from your table 1A, part 2, and a key. So a key is just something like this. I know I should make it better, but this is just rough idea. What is the key? It's just to show that which dot is which test tube. So the lines are not that accurate, but I try to make it look as nice. So this is just how it's going to look like. There will be 3 lines in total, and you must weigh the units and a suitable scale, and that's how you get your 5 marks. Okay, question part 4. State 2 conclusions for this investigation. So huddling, which can help to reduce heat loss or conserve more heat, or as the time increases the temperature falls slowly, the more test tube the slower the temperature drops or heat loss is lesser. Okay, part 5. State 2 variables that were kept constant during this investigation. I have written same time intervals and same test tubes. Okay. Part 6. Suggest 2 possible sources of error in this investigation. So the source of the error I found in here is that the starting temperature can be different, or the volume of the water can be different, or no band around 1 test tube, bands only on 3 and 7 test tubes, and then be no insulating effect. The band tightness is not the same way and it could vary, and there could be a change in environmental conditions. Part 7. Suggests 1 improvement to the method that was used in this investigation. So it's using the same volume of water or repeating the whole investigation at least twice or more. Part 8. Identify 1 hazard for this investigation. So the use of hot water can burn hands if spilled, all the breakage of glass if it has fallen on the ground. Okay? Part B. In mammals, respiration releases heat energy to maintain an optimum temperature for enzyme activity in the body. Amylase is an enzyme that catalyzes the breakdown of starch into reducing sugars. Prepare an investigation to identify the temperature at which the enzyme amylase is most active. So this is my answer for this 6 marks question. Okay, so prepare all the apparatus needed for this investigation. So the first sentence is just like a starter. The three temperatures used in this experiment are 20 degrees, 40 degrees, and 70 degrees. The temperature is maintained using a thermostatically controlled water bath. At the same time, the concentration and the volume of the amylase enzyme solution will be the same at all times. And then the result is determined by the first time the color begins to change using a Benedict solution. A colorimeter can be used if the color cannot be seen clearly by the Benedict Regan. Ensure the gloves and goggles are worn to prevent spillage of hot water during the investigation. And make sure repeat the investigation twice or more to ensure a fair investigation. Okay, this is a 6 marks question basically. So how do you get 6 marks is by mentioning one independent variable, one dependent variable. At least you can write 3 constant variables and a different kind of methods like using a colorimeter, using a thermostatically controlled water bath, that is also an extra step, and also using a Benedict solution will also help as an extra step. And then make sure you mention that you're going to repeat the investigation or twice or more at least, and a safety precaution will get you 1 mark guarantee if you write this part. Okay, question 2A. Some plants lose their leaves in the winter and grow new leaves in the spring. A scientist measured the total leaf area on the leaves on one grapevine plant. They repeated this on 100 grapevine plants and found the mean total leaf area per plant. This procedure was done every 2 months for 1 year. The results are shown in figure 2.1. Part 1. Suggest why a large number of plants were sampled. So, of course, it's to get a larger representative sample and it's to avoid bias, to identify anomalies in the process, to increase the reliability of the results. Okay, this is 1 mark, so just write any one of them. Part 2, estimate the mean total leaf area per plant for month 7. Show on figure 2.1 how you estimated this value. So you just have to draw a line and see, estimate where is it from. So to me, I found it's 3.3 meter square. Make sure you indicate this on the graph. Part 3. Using the information in figure 2.1, calculate the percentage increase in the mean total leaf area per plant from month 4 to month 6. Okay, so give your answer to 2 significant figures. Space for working is here. So from month 4 to month 6 is, one is at 1.4 and one is at 2.2. So the formula for this is final minus initial over initial times 100. So you get 57.1428, but you have to round to 2 significant figures, so the answer is just 57%. Okay? Part B. Figure 2.2 shows the leaf from grapevine of a grapevine plant. Using the grid to determine the area of the grapevine leaf shown in figure 2.2 by counting the squares containing the leaf. Only count squares that are more than half filled by the leaf, including the unit. Okay? So you just have to count how many squares are there and then calculate the area. So the accepted range is between 59 to 66 centimeters square. So 1 mark for a between the range answer, and 1 is for the area of the 1 is the unit of the area. Okay. Part C. Grapevines produce fruit called grapes. A large leaf area is important when growing grapes because the leaves supply reducing sugars to the grapes. Describe the method of testing for reducing sugars. Include the result for a positive test. So the method is to add Benedict solution and heat it up. So 1 mark is for adding Benedict solution, and 1 is by heating it up. And a positive test is the brick red in color, or you can also mention other positive colors like green color, yellow color, orange color, red, brown, or brown in color. Okay. Part D. Figure 2.3 is a photograph for a leaf from a fig plant. Make a large drawing of the leaf. So this is just an example of a large drawing, but the requirements of getting 4 marks is by make sure you have a clear line, one single line, and then the size is about 65 mm wide. And number 3 is having 5 lobes, meaning 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 lobes. And number 4 is 1 main vein in each lobe. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 veins. Okay, just like this, then you get your 4 marks. All right. Part E. State one similarity and one difference between the grapevine leaf in figure 2.2 and the fig leaf in figure 2.3. So the similarity is that it has the same number of lobes, the presence of veins, the patterns of veins, and an uneven edge. And the difference is that the grapevine leaves have fewer veins in comparison with the fig leaf, which has more veins. Or you can see that the grapevine leaves has more sharp, pointy lobes, and the fig leaf having smooth and wavy, rounded lobes. Okay, so that's all for this paper. So in my opinion, this paper is challenging in the graph drawing, for example. And then maybe some of the, I won't really say it's the calculation, but mostly I think this paper is the hardest is the graph question. Then other than that, it's just normal a paper 6 question. So I hope you enjoyed this video. To see you guys next time. Bye bye.